Good morning, dear students. I hope you are all feeling well today. And let us continue our studies in the coordination compounds part 2. So today we shall see stability constant. How this stability constant is depending upon the coordination compounds. In other words, how the coordination compounds are depending upon this stability constant. According to J. Jerron, E. Silent there. So J. Jerron, in 1941, he proposed this concept. What he says is, the coordination compounds are formed not by at once mixing the reactants, that is metal ion solutions with the ligand solutions. He says, a coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand solution. I repeat what I said. According to Jerron, a coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand. Now let us see generally how a coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand. In two ways it forms. Let us study the first way. So the first way how the coordination formed, I will write like this. This is metal ion solution combines with the ligand to form coordination compound ML. And I will write, according to the law of mass action, K1 is equal to molar concentration of product, that is coordination compound, upon the molar concentration of the reactants, that is metal ion solution and the ligand. So here K1 is called as the dissociation constant. In other words, here it is stepward formation constant K1, right? Now it continues. ML that is formed here combines with the ligand once again to form ML2, and K2 is, I will write, ML2 concentration, the molar concentration of ML2 divided by concentration of ML and L. Then this ML2 combines with another ligand to form ML3, and K3 we shall write, K3 is molar concentration of ML3 divided by the product of molar concentration of ML2 and concentration of L. So it continues like this. And finally we write the general equation like this. L n minus 1 plus L giving rise to ML n it is. So where n is equal to 1. So generally now we can write KN is equal to, I will write, the molar concentration of MLN divided by the product of molar concentration of MLN minus 1 into molar concentration of L. So here this K1, K2, K3 up to KN are called as stepwise formation constants. Followed what I said? This K1, K2, K3, dash dash KN are called as stepwise formation constant. You know, stepwise stability formation constant. Better I will say like this. They are called stepwise stability formation constants. So you are observing here, K1, K2, K3 dash KN, they are directly depending upon what? The product that is formed. So the stability formation constant is directly depending upon what? The product form. In other words, the formation of the coordination compound depends upon the stability formation constant. Now the other way of forming, other way of forming the coordination compound is, I will write like this. So second method of formation of the coordination compound, the stepwise formation. So first step as it is M plus L giving rise to ML, and I will write here beta 1 that is equal to molar concentration of ML divided by the product of molar concentration of M and L. So where beta 1, once again it is step 1 stability formation constant. Now second, ML combines, this metal combines with the 2 times ligand to form ML2. Followed this method, M plus 2 times ligand. So now beta 2 is equal to ML2 divided by molar concentration of M and molar concentration of L raised to the power 2, here because the coefficient number is 2. Similarly, M plus 3L giving rise to ML3, therefore beta 3 I will write, molar concentration of ML3 divided by molar concentration of M into molar concentration of L raised to the power 3. So if we continue like this, here I will write M plus, this is ML giving rise to ML N it is. So dash dash dash, now beta N I will write it as molar concentration of the product MLN divided by molar concentration of M into molar concentration of MLN. So this beta 1, beta 2, dash dash, this beta N are called as overall formation constants. Overall formation constants are overall stability constants. First we have seen K1, K2, K3, dash dash KN, we called them as stability, stepwise stability formation constants. Now here B1, B2, dash dash up to BN are called as overall stability constants. Right? Now when you see the first one and now the second one, it becomes like this. B1 is equal to K1. Is it right? Because the step 1 remains the same. Now B2, that is beta 2, is K1 and K2. It is the product of K1 and K2. Is it right? Because it is including 2 steps of the K1. Then beta 3 is equal to what? K1, K2, K3. Is it right? And so on. Finally, we can write beta N is equal to K1, K2 dash dash up to K. Is it okay? So these are the 2 general methods we have learned where a coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand. Is it okay? So now what is the definition of this stability constant then? Look, It is the ratio of the molar concentration of the product, that is coordination compound formed, to that of the product of molar concentration of the reactants. Which are the reactants? Metal ion solution and ligand solution. Is it okay? So I will repeat this definition. The stability constant is defined as the ratio of the molar concentration of the products to that of the product of the molar concentration of the reactants. So you learned in both the cases, the formation of a coordination compound is directly depending upon the stability constant. So larger is the value of stability constant, greater will be the stability of the coordination compound that is formed. Is it okay? So these are the two general methods suggested by Jerram, how a coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand. Now I will take one compound and explain how that coordination compound is formed by the stepwise addition of the ligand. We will take cadmium 2 solution, that is a solution containing cadmium plus 2 ions, and mix this with aqueous ammonia, and it will form a complex like this, tetramine cadmium 2 ion, tetramine cadmium 2 ion. So when we mix a solution containing cadmium plus 2 ions, mix that with aqueous ammonia, we get a coordination compound, tetramine cadmium 2 ion. Now let us see how this coordination compound or complex ion is formed by the stepwise addition of this ammonia ligand. Now the first step is, solution containing cadmium ion, to this solution when we add aqueous ammonia, we get the first complex ion like this. Amine, it is mono, right? Amine cadmium 2 ion. That is first one. Now, second step is that monoamine cadmium 2 ion further combines with the ligand ammonia to form CDNH3 twice plus 2 ion. That is diamine cadmium 2 ion. Then the third step, that diamine cadmium plus 2 ion combines with the ammonia ligand once again to form CDNH3 thrice plus 2, that is triamine cadmium 2 ion. Then the last step is that cadmium, that is triamine cadmium 2 ion, combines with once again the ligand ammonia to form CDNH3-4 plus 2, that is tetramine cadmium plus 2 ion. Look here. So this complex ion, tetramine cadmium 2 ion, is formed in 4 steps like this. Now let me write the stability formation constant values. For the first step, K1 is 10^2.6. For the second step, the stability formation constant K2 is 10^2.1. Then for the third step, the stability formation constant is equal to 10^1.4. Then for the fourth step, stability formation constant K4 is 10^0.9. Look at these stability formation constant values. You are noticing that they are in the decreasing order. First one is 10^2.6, second one is 10^2.1, and so on. The last one is 10^0.9. Why these stability formation constants are decreasing when this complex is finally getting formed? This complex number one is more stable than the second one. This diamine cadmium 2 ion is more stable than this triamine cadmium 2 ion, which is more stable than tetramine cadmium 2 ion. So this is more stable than this. This is more stable than this, and this one is more stable than the last one. What could be the reasons for this? Why the stability of the coordination compounds, for example in this case, are decreasing? That could be the reasons like this. The first reason is, look here, when this ammonia ligand is approaching this cadmium 2 ions, it has got, let me explain this pictorially. This cadmium 2 ion has got 4 ligands attached to this. This ligand may be either Cl or the other ligands. Now ammonia is approaching this cadmium. So this ammonia has got 4 possibilities. It can replace this ligand, this ligand, this ligand, and any one of this. So therefore, this is called a statistical factor. Is it right? The stability depends upon what? The statistical factor. So in the first step, it can replace any one of these ligands and form a complex like this. Is it okay? So that's why the first complex ion has got the high stability constant value, 10^2.6. Now in the second step, now once again, if the ammonia is approaching this complex ion that is formed, the possibilities are becoming less. Is it right? In the second step, the statistical factor is becoming less. In the first one, you are saying there are 4 possibilities. Now only there are 3 possibilities. Right? This ammonia can replace either this or this or this. So possibilities, the statistical factor has decreased. Therefore, the second complex ion, that is diamine cadmium 2, has got less stability constant value, that is 10^2.1. So if the second one is replaced like this. Now for the third one, again the statistical factors, it has got only 2 possibilities, therefore it can replace any one there. Is it right? Hence the third compound that is formed has got the stability value less than the second one, that is 10^1.4, and so on. So the first factor on which the stability formation constant value, in other words, the stability of the coordination compound, depends upon what? The statistical factor. Now what could be the second factor on which the stability formation values depends, or the stability of the coordination compound formed depends, is steric hindrance, in other words, geometrical hindrance. Followed what I am telling? The second factor on which the formation of a coordination compound depends upon, the geometrical hindrance, steric hindrance, See here, ammonia is approaching this cadmium 2 solution. Now when it is approaching, yes, it has replaced one ligand like this. Is that okay? Now to replace the second ligand by ammonia, if this ammonia ligand is more bulkier than the L that I have done earlier, right? If it is more bulkier than this, it can, if there is only a little space left here, see already this ammonia has occupied more space around this cadmium. Now for the second ammonia ligand approach, there is what? A geometrical hindrance. Okay, it has occupied here space. Is it okay? Now when it has occupied, it has also occupied more space around this cadmium ion. Now for the third ligand to come and replace this, it becomes difficult because the NH3 groups, the ligand are more larger than the L ligand that I have written. Therefore, the stability is decreasing. So the second factor on which the stability of the coordination compound depends is what? The geometrical hindrance. The geometrical hindrance, or I said it is spheric hindrance. And the third factor on which the stability of the coordination compound depends is repulsion that is occurring between the ligands. See, for example, if cyanide ligand is replacing this Cl, is it okay? So here there is a Cl. Now if another Cl is coming here, which are negative ligands, so there will be a repulsion between this cyanide ligand and this cyanide ligand. So when there is a repulsion, is it okay? So the stability of the coordination compound decreases. Followed this, so the first stability formation of a coordination compound depends on what I said. It depends upon statistical factor. Number two, the stability formation of a coordination compound is depending upon what? The geometrical hindrance. And the third one is Coulombic factor. I said it is what now? Coulombic factor. That is, when the ligands are occupying, replacing the earlier ions, there are ligands. So the fresh ligands, they may experience what? The repulsion between them, and hence the stability goes on decreasing. So that's why the stability formation values in the formation of this tetramine cadmium 2 ion goes on decreasing because of those three factors. Followed this, dear students. So we shall continue from this in the next class, and till then, have a nice day. Thank you very much.